You're watching the Red Zone Sports Show on Fox 5.
Straight ahead in the Red Zone, UNLV aims high and guts out a wild matinee at the MAC. We're breaking down the win against Air Force and Tuesday's game against San Diego State. Plus, two roadies this week to preview as UNLV fights to push up the standings. And we feature point guard Jovan Mooring, the attribute in JoJo that makes him go-go. The Red Zone is calling glass, and you know we aren't leaving early. Time to warm up. It's 30 minutes of UNLV hoops right now.
103, Rebels on 6. 1, 2, 3, Rebels, 4, 5, 6, Rebels.
This is the Fox 5 Red Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie, your home, your way.
Good evening. Welcome inside the Red Zone. Kevin Bollier alongside Running Rebels head coach Marvin Menzies coming off a thrilling victory against Air Force. But before we get to those games, the big news of the week, Dewayne Morgan out for the rest of the season with those injuries. You're going to file for the medical redshirt, and that could be huge to get him for two more years.
Yeah, it will be. And I'm going to raise my seat up on the next break because you look like you're about 6'8 right now. Dewayne was expecting to come back initially. We felt like it was going to be something where we could get him back in, you know, mid-conference was the hope. But it's just been lingering on and on, and it's gets every time it gets tweaked a little bit, it's almost like a full re-injury. So we've selected, and the doctors have basically selected to shut him down, and we'll apply for a medical redshirt at the end of the season.
Well, Morgan hasn't been in the lineup since December. The Rebels have been winning without him. We start our look back of the week with Saturday's win in double overtime against Air Force.
103, Rebels on 6. 1, 2, 3, Rebels, 4, 5, 6, Rebels.
The Running Rebels and Air Force and the Falcons jumped out quickly, scoring the game's first 7 points, including this three by Hayden Graham. UNLV got on the board with a Jalen Poyser offensive rebound and lay-in. Then Uche Ofebu drives to the hole. And when Christian Jones made the power move for the basket, the Rebs had their first lead of the game at 11-9. That's when JoJo Mooring started bombing threes. And we mean deep threes. Jimmer Fredette-length threes. Four of them over a 7-minute stretch. Some great ball movement here on this possession, and a baseline bounce pass from JoJo to Ofebu for the corner triple. Then Tyrell Green works inside. He gets the hoop in the harm. UNLV played a solid first half and led at the break 33-25. The second half was not a thing of beauty for either team as they struggled to get shots to fall. But Air Force went on a 17-0 run early in the half as Graham and Jacob Vann started getting hot, and the Rebels were locked into a tight game the rest of the way. Clyburn hit a three, but the Rebs tried to get a little too flashy at times. Mooring on the break with Baxter, and the alley-oop goes awry to come away empty. 1:27 to go. Zach Coker hits a three to make it a 4-point Air Force lead. The Green answers back with a triple to cut it to one. After some missed free throws by both sides, Poyser was at the line for a second free throw down three late. He has to miss on purpose. The ball goes out of bounds off of Air Force, and UNLV had a chance to tie it on the inbounds with 2.6 seconds left. The ball to Mooring. JoJo for the tie. Yes, sir. Watch again here as Mooring gets some space and goes glass. The MAC goes nuts, and we were headed to overtime. In OT, we were tied at 67 with under 10 to play. Mooring again from Boulder City, and he knocks it home for the lead with 3.2 seconds left. Air Force calls timeout, and Vann is the driver on this final play. The length of the court, and he banks in a three of his own to send the game into a second overtime. Starting the second OT, perhaps an overlooked but critical play. Christian Jones with a baseline jumper to settle the Rebels back in. And when Poyser drives to the hole to beat the shot clock, UNLV had a 7-point lead with 1:21 left. But this game was far from over as the Rebels missed critical free throws down the stretch, and Air Force climbed back in with a couple of threes. Mooring, though, would knock down four free throws late to seal this one up. Certainly not textbook shooting by both schools, but a win's a win, and UNLV gutted this one out, beating Air Force in double overtime, 87-85.
That's how they get going, is, you know, people fall asleep on defense, and they backdoor you. They're very disciplined team. And we didn't let that affect us.
Coach has been preaching all year, next possession. So, I mean, I made a shot, and they came down and made a bigger shot, and you just got to move on from it. And we continue to execute, and that's the reason we got the W.
JoJo Morin was playing horse out there. It seemed like the old Larry Bird, Michael Jordan commercials, yeah. But he was knocking those down.
Well, first thing I told him when we came in at the halftime is you took some horrible shots today. I'm glad you made a couple. I'm glad you made the ones that, you know, sent it to overtime, win the game, but he can play so much better. And, you know, I'm not going to let him think that just because he made some tough horse shots that he had a good basketball game. He didn't. But I'm glad he made the shots. Don't get me wrong. And he has a little freedom. He knows he has some freedom with me because he can make those tough shots, and he practices them in practice. He is one of the few guys that can take a deep three, and I'm okay with it a little bit as long as he has time and space. But I want him to get better. You know, I want him to play better. I want him to limit the turnovers. We're always going to push him to have a better floor grade. People always love the flash of the big shot, right? That's the entertainment factor. I got to get him to be a great basketball player. And I think there's a lot of room for growth with that kid. But, man, he's already got so much that he brings to the table. And that toughness and that confidence to make those shots was – you can't coach that. He brought that when I recruited him.
There were some stretches, though, where you guys went without a field goal. And we've seen that throughout the year. How concerned are you moving forward that this team is going 4, 5, 6 minutes without getting a bucket?
You know, I am concerned. I'm concerned that I feel that, you know, I'm not scared to say it. I feel like we're putting them in positions to get good shots. I mean, we're missing layups. You know, we're right at the basket. You got 6'10", 6'8", you know, shooting over guys that are a little, you know, shorter than them, and they're right at the basket. They got to finish. So I'm concerned in that sense that I feel like we're getting there and we're just not finishing. But then you watch them in practice, Kevin, and it's like, man, we're pretty good. I mean, you know, we make those shots. So I don't know what it is, but we just got to get more comfortable with seeing that ball go in the basket, not just in practice now, but in the games. We've got to get a few games back where we're scoring at a high rate and getting out and running and getting some easier buckets. And that all starts with making free throws, getting deflections, getting runouts, you know, those kinds of things. Then you can get going. I think when you're just teeing it up from the three, I thought we took way too many threes. I thought we settled, you know. The strength of that scouting report should have been inside out, right? With the size advantage we had. So we're a work in progress still, but I want to get these lessons with the W, so I'll take last night anytime.
It is a whole lot easier with the W. On the flip side, there was Tuesday night, rival San Diego State in town. This was a tale of two halves. There's always a special vibe in the building when UNLV and San Diego State play, and these two teams came out slugging. Uche Ofebu came out firing, hitting the triple to get the Rebels out of the gate. Then JoJo Morin follows with a three of his own, and Christian Jones knocks down a jumper to give the Rebels an early lead. Morin got a little sloppy and turned the ball over in the backcourt, leading to a finger roll from Trey Kell. And then JoJo picked up his second foul just 4 minutes into the game. He had to go to the bench. The Rebels pressed on. Ofebu hit another from long distance. CJ gets the lay-in and hits a 12-footer. And Chekne Dembele works inside. He gets the hoop in the arm. That would open the UNLV lead to 6. Morin re-entered and knocks down a jumper. At the same time, an off-ball foul was called. The Rebels got the points and possession. On that possession, Jalen Poyser beat the shot clock with the circus shot. The Aztecs would make a late push in the first half, and when they hit this three with 12 seconds to go, San Diego State went into the locker room with a 34-31 lead.
the second half did not get off to a great start as Morey picked up his third and fourth fouls in the first 72 seconds. That would send him back to the bench. The Rebs, though, hung tough. Ofebu drives to the rim for the lay-in. Jones works his man for the bucket. Morey would re-enter with 13:31 left, and he picks up the goaltending call and one. The long court pass to Poyser led to a lay-in. UNLV was down only two at 44-42 with 9:56 to go. The Rebels scored only 9 points the rest of the way. The Aztec defense smothered UNLV and they struggled offensively. That is when Kell essentially took this game over. The three ball to open the SDSU lead. Then the pump fake and drive to the hole and the exclamation point on the alley-oop. San Diego State does what they do best, clamp down on defense as the Rebels score only 20 second half points with only two assists as the Aztecs pull away 64-51.
In games, you're going to go through parts where, you know, you had to fight through adversity. Things are not going to go your way. Coach talked about that before the game started, how we there's going to be a stretch where offensively we weren't going to click. I mean, that might be like a little two-minute stretch, but just keep going through it and we're going we'd have a chance to prevail. But I think we let that kind of like linger and held us back. San Diego State is one of the hardest teams, you know, to deliver like a KO to them, you know, have their morale like defeated, but you know, they stayed with it.
There are not many programs in the country that are capable of clamping down defense better than San Diego State. They can really turn a game quickly, mm-hmm. and we saw that in the second half with what they did.
You know, and it's funny how you keep hearing about they're not the San Diego State of old, and they've lost their edge. And I'm like going, they have the 25th best defensive field goal percentage, you know, and they're still really, really good at guarding the ball. You know, I think that it's a team that when you play against them, you have to share the ball, and we didn't. You know, in the second half we got that lead, and then we were down, they got the lead, and then we turned into a lot of me shots again. And that's just a virus that keeps coming back into our system from time to time, and we've got to find a way to you know, latch on to what's working. And what's working is when we share the ball, and what's working is making the extra pass, you know, drawing, making two guys play, you find somebody, dribbling with the intent to get someone else a shot, rather than let me see if I can get to the basket. Oh, you know, we'll see if they stop me or not. I mean, you just saw in the highlights, I mean, how many times did we go in and shoot the ball in a crowd? That's just bad basketball. And I don't care how good you are defensively or how bad you are. You play that type of offense, you're not going to be very successful the majority of the time.
Well, the Running Rebels get another shot at them in mid-February. Last week behind us, now it's time to pay close attention to this week. Straight ahead, we break down roadies in Wyoming and San Jose as the Rebels look at becoming road warriors. That's in 2 minutes. Stick and stay.
You're watching the Fox 5 Reb Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie, your home, your way.
It is a road trip week for the Rebels, who play in Wyoming and at San Jose State.
Wednesday night in Laramie, UNLV plays Wyoming for the second time in 8 games. On New Year's Eve at the Thomas and Mack, the Running Rebels played a solid game in beating the Cowboys 81-75, frustrating their best shooter in Jason McManaman and taking Wyoming out of everything they wanted to do. They'll look for a repeat performance, but it'll be a little more difficult on the road in a tough travel destination that has the team playing at 7,220 feet in elevation. And the Cowboys make sure to remind teams they're in low oxygen territory.
I think it does sometimes give us a little bit more energy. You know, you see other teams, they come and sometimes they have to get the tank out with oxygen just because of that altitude, it really does affect you.
X's and O's wise, the Cowboys have stuck with their trademark tight defense, but under new head coach Allen Edwards have picked the pace up on the offensive side, trying to create more tempo than we've seen in the past.
Hopefully we'll try and, you know, speed it up a little bit and get some easy transition. You know, threes or dunks, but I mean, at the same time, it's, you know, our identity is on the defensive end, getting stops, getting defensive rebounds.
The first time around, 5 Rebels scored in double figures, and UNLV forced 16 turnovers while holding Wyoming to 5 of 26 from three-point range. Another stellar effort is needed. On Saturday, the week of roadies continues as UNLV heads to the Bay Area to take on San Jose State. The Spartans have not challenged a lot of teams since coming into the Mountain West, but this year is a different story, where Dave Wojcik has players competing hard and winning some games.
I think they'll see a team that is an athletic team, a team that's going to play extremely hard and very aggressively. And I think we'll have great chemistry that they'll see. We share the ball.
San Jose State has 65% of its scoring returning from last season. The Spartans aren't the biggest team, but they're pesky and lead the Mountain West in turnover margin. UNLV will have to shut down Brandon Clark, who is among the conference leaders in points scored and field goals made. Take him out of the mix, and the Rebels have a good shot at picking up a big road win.
Let's start with Wyoming. You guys did a great job the first time around. What's the key this time around to picking up a road win in Laramie?
Well, some of the same. If it's not broke, don't fix it, right? So we've got some things that we're expecting that they're going to do a little bit differently. Obviously, if you lose against a team, then you got to try to tweak some things. So we're going to try to anticipate some of those. But a lot of that will be, game day, game time, adjustments. I think it'll be one of those types of games. But we got to hone in on really the things that we've been doing well and try to do those better. How we play the zone. Our man-to-man defense is improving in spurts. So we've got to just try to get better defensively.
Saturday in San Jose, we talked about taking Brandon Clark. UNLV has been very effective in taking a team's primary scorer out of the game and making somebody else beat you. That's going to be the case on Saturday as well.
Yeah, you always want to do that. Obviously, it didn't work well against San Diego State because somebody else stepped up. Kel stepped up. We did a good job on Hemsley, and Kel stepped up. But, we'll have a plan in place, and it's up to the players to go out and execute it. But we've been successful in that area for sure.
We're looking forward to those road trips. We're going to take a short break right now. On the backside, though, a profile on JoJo Morey. What makes the Running Rebels point guard tick? And what's the one word he uses to describe his game? Find out next as the Red Zone rolls off.
You're watching the Fox 5 Red Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie, your home, your way.
One of the breakout players for UNLV this season has been Jovan Mooring, who gets introduced with his given name, but he prefers to go by JoJo. No matter what you call him, JoJo's playing a key role in UNLV's season.
If you watch Running Rebel games, one player tends to jump out at you, JoJo Mooring. His game has progressed throughout the season with defense, hustle, and intensity, and that has him in the starting lineup now as UNLV's point guard. Mooring says things are starting to come together with this team.
I think we're definitely getting much more comfortable, and we're buying in, and I think everyone is responding to what coach wants. But it's always room for improvement.
Mooring has taken an abnormal route to Division I ball. Grades prevented him from taking a scholarship to Memphis, so he went to a junior college in Texas before having to move home to Chicago for family reasons. After taking a year off, Mooring went back to a JC in Illinois and became the JUCO Division II Player of the Year, averaging more than 26 points a game. It was actually Chris Beard in his 7 days of employment at UNLV that first targeted Mooring. Marvin Menzies jumped in to make sure that he came to Las Vegas. And JoJo knows he's taken a huge step up in competition.
Every time I stepped on the court in junior college, I was clearly the best player. And I knew that. But now it's like, I really have to play. Like, it's no joke with these other guys that could do the same things that I can do. And there are other guys that are more athletic, quicker, faster. It's a part of this level.
Fans look at the steals or the scoring or assists, but Mooring wants to be known for one thing.
Toughness. That's one thing I pride myself on. Even if I have a bad game, I wouldn't let someone else out-tough me. And that's just my mindset.
That brings us back to his upbringing, where you were tough or you got torn up on the court.
In Chicago, you play on the playground growing up, and it builds a lot of toughness.
That's translated to the court in Las Vegas, where JoJo can take a licking and keep on ticking.
All right, one final break for us. We're coming back with the Running Rebels Plays of the Week right after this.
You're watching the Fox 5 Reb Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie. Your home, your way.
Rebels at 3-4 in the conference. Big week this week. Come back over 500 would be pretty nice.
That'd be really nice. We gotta lay the table for the rest of the the rest of the conference slate.
We are looking forward to it. Wednesday night in Laramie, Saturday at San Jose State before they return home to Las Vegas the week after that. Thanks for joining us inside the Reb Zone this Sunday. We leave you with the Running Rebels Plays of the Week. Good night.
Let's go.
I tried to cover my shine. I tried to stay in the lines. I don't want to hide. No, not tonight. Ready or not, here I come. I'm about to show you where the light comes from. Oh, ready or not, here I come. This is who I am, I won't hide it. I'ma take it all over the world. To the young, to the old, every boy and girl. Ready or not, here I come. I'ma show the world where the love is.
I refuse to keep this buried deep inside of me. Yeah, this little light of mine, it's time to let it shine a bit. Cause there's no point in hiding it, it's everything I am. The source of all my hope and it's the reason why I stand. I pledge allegiance to being somebody real. There's no more holding it back, I'm showing them how I feel. Cause love is more than a word, it's a noun and a verb. And hiding is absurd, you heard?
Ready or not?
Fox 5 Reb Zone Sports Show was presented by RC Willie. Your home, your way.